Hey guys, hi, very good evening to all of you and welcome to the session. This is your master teacher Harsh Priyam and I am in front of all of you with this new topic that is real numbers third session. So this is class 10th chapter first of CBSE NCERT and in this chapter we are going to talk about the decimal representation of a number. Okay, so I hope you all must be pretty ready for starting this new topic. Chalo, so let's start and let me tell you before starting that this is with respect to standard mathematics. Okay, so I hope that would be clear to all of you. Chalo, so let's start before starting. So here we go. Now this is the first thing, rational numbers and their decimal representation. So here you all should know one thing, that for all the decimal representation, what we look at is the denominator of any fraction. So say for example, if any fraction is in the form of p by q, we primarily focus on the q because this q is going to give us the decimal representation, or we can convert a fraction into decimal using this q. So we'll be primarily concentrating on this q. Here only one important thing that you have to take care in your mind is that this p by q should be in their simplest form. Here it should not be that there is any other common factor is coming out. So it should be in the simplest form. They should be coprimes. Fine. Chalo. If you have understood this, so the first result which you have to take care is that any number which can be expressed in the form of p by q, you have to first of all express it in the form of p by q, where p and q will be in the simplest form. No further common factor should be coming. So they should be coprime. Once you have got that, after that, your objective should be that check for q, and here, if you're finding the prime factorization of q, mind it what I'm saying, you have to find the prime factorization of q, and once you find the prime factorization of q, thereafter, you have to check that whether that prime factorization is having power of 2 and power of 5, is it having that? And second thing, that is it having only these two numbers or any other numbers? What I mean to say is, see, here is a concept of friend numbers and non-friend numbers. What is this? I'll just tell you. So please pay attention here. So you have you have friend numbers and you have non-friend numbers. Friend numbers and non-friend numbers. Now, what are friend numbers? So, friend numbers are 2 and 5. Only 2 and 5. Nothing else. Okay? And non-friend numbers are all others. Okay? Now, what is the concept? Concept says that if you have got any fraction, say for example, let's take an example, 7 by 25. Or say for example, 7 by, you take it like 9 by 100. You've got two examples here. This is in the simplest form because it cannot be further reduced. So in 7 by 25, look at the denominator, do the prime factorization of denominator. If you will do, you will get 5 square. Similarly here, check them. Are they in the simplest format? If yes, then take this denominator, do the prime factorization. So you will get 2 square into 5 square. In your denominator, if you are getting only friend numbers, only 5 or 2 and 5 because they are friend numbers. If you are getting only friend numbers, then this type of fraction is going to give you terminating decimal. Again, repeating, this type of fraction is going to give you terminating decimal. Okay. Now, how about non-terminating decimal? So, in this denominator itself, say for example, you have got any other number 23 divided by 60. Fine. So this is again in the simplest format. Here again you will do the prime factorization of the denominator. So prime factorization of the denominator means the 60. If you do the prime factorization of the 60 will get converted into like, if I'm not wrong, it should be 2 square into 3 into 5. See, there are friend numbers, but there is an introduction of a non-friend number as well. So whenever you see in denominator, there is any number which is non-friend number, at that point of time, you have to understand that surely this is going to give you a non-terminating decimal. I guess that is clear. I'm again repeating that you have to go for a fraction. In that fraction, you have to check for p by q. In that p by q, once this is in the simplest form, you will do the prime factorization of the denominator. Once you do prime factorization, it will give you two type of results. Either the result will be having only the factors of 2 and 5, only the factors of 2 and 5, or the result will have any other non-friend number as well. It can have 2 and 5 also, but along with that, it should have any number which is other than 2 and 5. Or it can have primarily all the numbers which is other than 2 and 5. So in that case, you have to write 2 raised to power m, 5 raised to power n. They might be there, they might not be there. But there should be a presence of any other number. Any other number should be there. In this situation, you can just write it a by b. P we have already used. In this situation, this is going to give you non-terminating decimal and this is going to give you terminating decimal. I hope now it is much more clear. So these are the results which has been written here for you guys. You can just go through that. Terminating and non-terminating is done. Okay. And I'll be explaining these things much better with the help of a question. Chalo. So let's get into the question. So 2 raised to power n, 5 raised to power m. Everywhere you have to just concentrate on this 2 and 5. Nothing else. Okay. Chalo. So the first question. This first question says, without actually performing the long division, show that each of the following rational numbers is a non-terminating repeating decimal. Non-terminating and repeating decimal. Okay. Let's see. How are we going to show that? So first question. First question is given 77 upon 210. Please pay attention. First of all, we have to take care that this should be in the simplest format. Simplest format ka matlab kya? 7 will cancel it in 11 times. 7 will cancel it in 30 times. I hope now it is in simplest format. 11 by 30. If you have got 11 by 30, now if I talk about this 30, so it is going to 3 into 2 into 5. So you have friend numbers, but along with that, you have a non-friend number in the house. So if there is a non-friend number in the house, without any doubt, this is going to give you non-terminating decimal. So simple. Second example. So second question says 64 upon 455. Okay, so 455 is a big number. I also don't know the prime factorization, so we'll have to do. Chalo, let's try to do it that. So if I talk about 455, I'll do it with 5 first. So I have got 91. And this I know is 7 into 13. So what you got basically, this 64 is 2 raised to power 6. 2 raised to power 6. And if I talk about 455, so this is 5 into 7 into 13. So there are non-friend numbers in the house. In the denominator, you have got non-friend numbers. So if you have non-friend numbers, again, this will be non-terminating decimal. That's what we have to show every time. And the third one is 29 divided by 343. So I hope you are understanding that 29 is itself a prime number. But if I talk about 343, so do you know what is 343? I do remember, that's why I'll write it. So 343 is nothing but 7 cube. So if it is 7 cube, again a non-friend number. So if it is a non-friend number, you will be able to write here non-terminating decimal. Cool. By the way, let me tell you, this non-friend number is not a theoretical concept. So please don't write it in your examination paper that we have got non-friend numbers. That is why it is going to be non-terminating decimal. This is a concept which I have developed. So just for the sake of remembering that friend numbers, those numbers which will be there. And if they are there, things will be good. Terminating decimal. But there, other than friend, everyone or anyone, they all are threat. Anyone who is not a friend can be a threat. So at that point of time, it will be a non-terminating decimal. Okay, cool. Chalo, let's move on to the next one. So here we go for the solution as well. The same solution which we had done, 2 into 3 into 5. Similarly for the second one, we got 5 into 7 into 13. And the third one is 7 cube. So again, none of them are fitting in the friend number category. So that's why they are non-terminating. Next question. Chalo. So in this next question, what is said? It is said that express each of the following as fraction in simplest form, 0.24 bar. So this was a class 9th subject matter, isn't it? But still I have taken this question because I know that many of the students find it difficult in converting these type of numbers into p by q format. That is recurring format. Okay, chalo, let's see that. So if you have got a number, say for example 0.24, you'll first of all assume it x, 0.24 bar. Then the concept says that you have to actually multiply this number with 10 raised to power, such power, as many digits are inside the bar, as many digits are which are having bar on them. So you have got two digits, means you will multiply it with 10 raised to power 2. Isn't that simple? Once you got that, so 10 square means 100. You have got here 100x is equals to 100 once multiplied here. You'll have to do it or understand it by writing it in a rough copy if you're not understanding. So if you multiply 100 with 0.24 bar, you will get 24.24 bar. How is that if anyone is not understanding? 0.24 bar simply means 24 24 24 24 dot 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 dot. It simply means this much. If you are multiplying 100 with this, this means this decimal place is going to shift here. So you will get 24.24 24 24 24 24, so on. Means you have got 24.24 bar. That's why whenever we write this type of numbers, multiplication 100 or something like that, we just shift the decimal places, although the bar never gets removed. That is the idea. Chalo, if you have understood this much, so let's move on. Now you can simply subtract them. The first equation second equation minus the first. 100x minus x, you will get 99x is equals to 24 minus 0, that is 24.24 bar 24 bar. So 24 bar 24 bar subtracted, 0. You have got 99x is equals to 24.0. Once you have got this number, it's very easy now. You have got 24 by 99. If you want to further simplify it, you can cancel it with 3. You'll get 8 divided by 33. And that is the final answer. Isn't that simple, simple? Chalo, if you have understood this first one, let's try for the second one. That's a little different. So what we are going to do that there, okay, let me just go for the next. 0.365 bar. 0.365 bar. So bar is on 6 and 5, not on 3. Now in this situation, what you have to do, please pay attention over one thing, that in this situation, whenever you have a number like this, the first and the primary objective should be that after decimal, there should not be any digit which is not in the bar. I'm again repeating. The primary objective should be that there should not be any digit after a decimal. After a decimal, there should be not any single digit which is not in the bar. So here actually we have got a digit which is not inside the bar. So what should be the objective? Objective should be that first we should put this decimal here at this place. Means we have to move this decimal one place right side. So we are going to multiply this whole equation first by 10. Because 10 will move this decimal one place. So you have got 10 into x, that is 10x, is equals to 3.65 bar. Now, once you have got this, now you will perform the same operation what we did in the previous question. Previous question, what we did? We did that we will be multiplying this whole equation by 10 raised to that power, as many digits which are inside the bar. So we will multiply this whole equation by 10 raised to power, that there are two digits inside the bar, so 10 raised to power 2. So 10 raised to power 2 gives 100, 100 into 10, that is 1000x. 1000x is equals to, this 65 will come here, so it will be 365, 0.65 bar will not go, so it will be as it is. Now you will again subtract this. So 1000 minus 10, you have got 990x is equals to 365 minus 3, you have got 362, and 0.65 minus 0.65, so you have got a 0. So here you got x is equals to 362 divided by this 990 comes in the denominator. So you can just put it in the box and eureka, you have got the answer. Isn't that fine? Isn't that cool? Chalo, if you all have understood, let's move on. See the answer also. 8 by 33, what we also got. And second is 362 by 990, it can be further reduced. So if you want, you can reduce it further. You'll get 181 by 495. Balle balle? Chalo, if this is balle balle, let's move on. Here we go to the next question. Next question talks about that classify the following numbers as rational or irrational. I don't think I need to do that, isn't it? From childhood, you have been studying that, sir, pi is a irrational number. Pi is an irrational number. So without any doubt, I'll write here itself, it's an irrational number, just by theory. After that, I know 3.142857. It is inside the bar. Bar itself means बार इटसेल्फ मींस रिपीटिंग. बार मींस व्हाट? रिपीटिंग डेसिमल. एंड फॉर एन इरेशनल नंबर द डेफिनेशन इज प्रीटी सिंपल, प्रीटी सिंपल. बिकॉज फॉर इरेशनल नंबर द डेफिनेशन सेज दैट एनी नंबर, एनी डेसिमल नंबर विल बी इरेशनल इफ इट हैज गॉट नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग एंड नॉन रिपीटिंग डेसिमल. सो इन बोथ द केसेस इट इज नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग एंड नॉन रिपीटिंग. हियर इट इज रिपीटिंग. So there should not be any thought. If it is repeating, it can't be an irrational number. So it has to be a rational number. Means your second option is a rational number. Now let's talk about the third one. So in the third one, you have got a cube root of 3. Okay. So in the cube root of 3, again, for irrational number, there are two definitions. So this definition is for decimal representation. If you have a decimal representation, but say for example, if you have not got any decimal representation, so could that number be also an irrational? Yes. The idea is you should have any number, and then any number raised to power. Any number raised to power, always remember, non-integer. If this is the situation that you have got any number which has got any power which is not integer, in this situation it will be called as an irrational number. But mind it, I am saying it after a full simplification. You can't do any further simplification here. So say for example, I'll just give you an example. Let's take this example only. So you have got cube root 3. So cube root 3 means what? I hope you all must be knowing that cube root 3 simply means 1 by 3. Cube root 3 simply means 3 raised to power 1 by 3. That is the cube root. Okay. We can't further solve it, isn't it? Now say for example, so obviously this is any number raised to power non-integer. So we will call it irrational. Correct? But say for example, some student comes to me and says that sir, 27 raised to power 1 by 3. So sir, according to your theory, this is any number raised to power non-integer. This should also be an irrational number. I would say no. Why no? Because here there is a scope of simplification. What scope? For 27, you can very easily write 27 as 3 raised to power 3. That is possible. And then power 1 by 3 is there on the whole. So you will be able to cancel it. After cancellation, you will get 3 raised to power 1. So this is the final simplification. After this, you can't simplify further. So in this situation, since the simplification is possible, that is why we'll call it a rational number. I hope you all got it. So for a rational number, there are only two definitions that you have to remember for the whole of your life. That first, if it is a decimal representation, you have to remember it should be non-terminating and non-repeating. If it is a number representation, thirds, we call it thirds, then it should be any number raised to power non-integer. In that sense, it will be irrational. Fine. So we have got that the third one is irrational, second one is rational, first one is irrational. Simple. Eureka. Chalo, let's move on if you have understood this. So the same answer here also, non-terminating decimal. So irrational, thereafter rational, thereafter irrational. Cool. Let's move on. Here's the next question. It says, write the decimal expansion of 73 upon 2 raised to power 4 and 5 raised to power 3. How are we going to do that? Chalo, let's see. Here, it says that we have to do decimal expansion. So we have got 73 divided by 2 raised to power 4 into 5 raised to power 3. Cool. Now, there is always one method that you multiply it, you get the number, you divide it. But obviously, we are not going to do that because that is a long method. Always remember, you have to do one thing. You have to try to put the numbers in 10. You have to try to put the numbers in the denominator, in the format of 10. So if I talk about in the format of 10, 10 means what? 10 means simply 2 and 5. Okay. So this means if you have to put it in 10, this means you have to put it in the format of 2 and 5. That looks easy, man. But so what you have to see here is you have got 2 raised to power 4 and 5 raised to power 3. Don't you think 2 raised to power 4 means 2 raised to power 3 and 5 raised to power 3? Means you can write this entire number like this. Now you might be thinking, why did I do that? Because I am able to see that 2 and 5, this pair means we have got 3 pairs of it. 2 cube, 5 cube means I can actually write 2 into 5 whole cube. So this is already this number is already in format of 10. But only this 2 is remaining. it has not got any partner. So you have to just make sure that none of the numbers are alone. None of the factors of 2 and 5, they are alone. They should always have a partner. 2 should have a partner of 5. 5 should have a partner of 2. So if they are in partner, that's balle balle. So here I am able to find that 1, 2 is remaining alone. So what I'll do, I'll provide 1, 5. Obviously, it will not come free of cost. It will have a cost. What cost? You can't multiply a number on your own. You'll have to substitute for it. So you will multiply this 5 in the numerator as well. So what you did, that you found that here 2 is 1, 2 is extra. So that's why for compensating it, you multiplied 1, 5. For compensating this 5, you multiplied this 5 in the numerator as well. So what do you have got? Finally, you can write the same number as 73 into 5 divided by 2 raised to power 4 into 5 raised to power 4. Now this is absolutely fine. You have to just calculate it. So 73 into 5, I don't think that will be a big problem. I'll just write it here. 73 into 5, 5 se 15 ka 5, 1, 35, 36, 365 divided by 2 raised to power 4, 5 raised to power 4. So I can very easily write 10 raised to power 4. 10 raised to power 4, I don't think I need to take tension about it. Because 10 raised to power 4 simply means what? 4 places decimal shifted. So 4 places decimal shifted means 0.0365. Balle, balle. You have got the answer. Without any division. Although it will not take so much time. It took so much time for me because I was explaining you. But you will be able to solve it pretty fast. Let's see. Wait a second. What they did. Okay, so sorry for that. They have went into some other space. They have done it wrong because they have not multiplied here 5. So no issues. Let's cut this. Concentrate on this solution. This is absolutely right. Okay, so let's move on. So here we go to the next question. This is the next question. Show that there is no value of n for which this ends in 5. There is no value of n for which this ends in 5. Cool, man. Cool. Very cool. We will be able to show it. How? 2 raised to power n into 5 raised to power n means I can very easily write 2 into 5 whole raised to power n. So you have actually got 10 raised to power n. Now, there could be no method or no value of n for which a number having 10 and you can make it end in 5. There is not at all any possibility, isn't it? The minimum which you can take is 0. The minimum which you can take is 0. So 10 raised to power 0 will give you actually 1. And after that, whatever power you take, that will always give you 0 at the end. Okay, so not possible. Even if you take negative power, then also it's not possible. You can try. Take n equals to minus 1 or n equals to minus 2, then also it won't be possible. Okay, fine. Chalo. So if you all have understood till here, let's move on to the next question. So the same way, 10 raised to power n, which is always ends in 0. There is no value of n for which this ends in 5. Simple, straightforward. One liner or two liner, max to max. Here's the next question. The next question says that write down the decimal expansion of 14588 divided by 625 by writing its denominator in the form of 2 raised to power m into 5 raised to power n, where m and n are the non-negative integers. Good one. Chalo, dekhte hain how we are going to solve that. So I am able to see 14588 divided by 625. One thing is pakka sure that this 625 you all might be knowing. 25 square. Yaad karo. So if this is 25 square, so 25 is itself 5 square. So 5 square ka whole square means this is 5 raised to power 4. I did the prime factorization. Denominator done. Now, there is second question that, sir, we know that every time we have to take it in the simplest format. So won't you check for the simplest format? I would say no. Because I know that in the denominator, I have only 5. And the numerator will never get cancelled by 5. Because 5... multiple of 5 are those numbers which ends in 5 or 0. So that's why it is already in the simplest format. Cool. So write the decimal expansion. I have already taught you that if you have to write the decimal expansion, you should just take care of one thing, that none of the numbers should be alone. So here you have only got 5. 5 is all alone. All the 4 5s, 5 into 5 into 5 into 5, 4 times. All the 4 5s, they all are alone. So you have to actually provide 4 times 2. Means you have to actually multiply this number by 2 raised to power 4. But you can't multiply it on your own. So you'll have to compensate. So here you also you'll have to multiply 2 raised to power 4. So what do you actually got? You got 14588 into 16. 2 raised to power 4 is 16. So you will write here 14588 into 16, and that will be divided by 2 raised to power 4 into 5 raised to power 4. That is nothing but 10 raised to power 4. So this multiplication will actually be a tedious one. So if you want me to do that, I can do that. I can think of doing that. So 847 or 8412x28. Yeah, it looks like 128. 128. So I can do that. Chalo, I will do that. So 16 8 is 128 ka 8 haath mein laga 12 128 aur 12 ka matlab 130 140 ka 0 14 4 14 sorry ha to 16 85 80 94 haath mein laga 9 so 64 64 aur 74 73 ka 3 7 16 7 23 233408 divided by 10 raised to power 4. Dekho, I have done this multiplication only for you guys. Otherwise, I would have never done it. But anyways, 233408, 10 raised to power 4. So you will shift the decimal to 4 places. Or after decimal, there should be 4 digits. So this means you will write 233408 and the decimal will be here. Because after decimal, you should have 4 digits. You got the 4 digits. Okay, 23.3408. Let's check the answer as well. So, sorry, here we go. 23.3408. Yo, my calculation is good. Chalo. So, if you all have understood, did you understand it or not? First of all, tell me, did you all understand it or not? Samajh aaya? Yes? Okay, if you all have understood, that's really great. So, let's move on. Aage bade. Chalo. So, here we move on to the next one. Okay. That was all. So those students who liked it and who want to be a part of Vedantu and learn live online with me and many other master teachers, this is the link, this is the gateway. You can actually go to this website which says vdnt.in/ytpro. Here vdnt.in is in the small case, ytpro is in the capital letters. You can go to this link, check out all the courses, all the time periods. You can select the time period, grades, target, whatever you want. You can check out the prices, and after that you can apply this coupon code, which is HPE Pro. So this coupon code is my personal coupon code. It will allow you to get a discount of 15%, 15 to 20%, something around that. And once you apply this coupon code, you'll be able to get the reduced price of the course which you want to purchase. Fine. Why and what all benefits you will be getting in Vedantu. So those all benefits is that all the problems of online education has been tackled by Vedantu. So all such problems which you people used to face earlier has now been tackled out. How that they have been tackled out? It's only that your doubts, this was the biggest problem. You were not getting any support for that. Second thing was notes, that after the session, once session is over, what about the notes? Exam and assignments. Test and assignment, this was also a problem. Competitive examination preparation, all such big coaching institutes, they used to give you. So now Vedantu is also giving you. In fact, many of the students have done wonderfully well in competitive exams. Those who are only Vedantu students, they have done outstandingly well. So you can find out those results on the Vedantu page, vedantu.com. Apart from that, choice of schedule has also been given to you guys. So you can actually choose your own schedule, and you can see that at which time you are most comfortable in taking the sessions, and at that time you'll get the live session. Yes, so Vedantu can give you your choice of schedule. Isn't that balle balle? And last but not the least, that is the choice of language. So right now I'm speaking everything in English. So it is only because that we are committed towards your goal, your betterment. So we were getting a lot of response, a lot of requests from you guys only that, sir, probably we are not able to understand Hindi. We want an English communication and we want an English delivery or English speaking teacher. So that's why we bifurcated the channel itself. So here the bifurcation of channel was possible, so we did that. But in all other things, that was not possible from the YouTube platform. So we can't take your doubts, even if we want, we can't take your doubts through YouTube, isn't it? That would not be possible. So that's why we have launched our own Vedantu app. Notes, for that notes, once a student goes for a subscription, buys a subscription, he'll be able to get the notes in his login itself. You don't have to go anywhere, you don't have to download anything. You'll be able to see it at your portal itself. And there, if you want, you can download it as well. Test and assignment every consecutive fortnightly or weekly tests are conducted. After every session, you will get assignment also according to that session so that you can solve just those questions which you have studied in today in that session. So these all things, these all customary tailored products have been brought for you guys. And it's only because that you guys have shown such a huge love, respect and dedication towards Vedantu. You guys have put a lot of faith in Vedantu. That's why Vedantu is also repaying you back through these awesome and wonderful products at a very affordable price. Okay. Competitive exams, competitive exams support is also given by Vedantu. Schedule, I already said that you can choose your own schedule, and choice of language has been given in the batches as well. Okay, fine. And this is not all. Unlimited live classes you will be getting. So if you want, or if you have the capacity of taking more than 2 or 3 live sessions per day, you can go for even 10 live sessions per day. No one is going to stop you. You can get into multiple batches and you can learn from there. Isn't that great? And not only this, all micro courses and crash courses will be free of cost for you. You don't have to pay anything extra for that. Performance reports would be given to you on your mail ID and personalized attention would be given to you through a personal teacher. So these all features have made Vedantu a very super rich experience platform. And not only this, this is not my wordings, rather students say that. So many of the students who are right now even watching this video, they can tell you their experience. Many of them are already a Vedantu paid subscription member. So they can tell you how beautiful it is and are they enjoying or not and what is their experience. They can actually share it. So you can just check out anywhere, wherever you want. You will get wonderful response. Okay, fine. So that was all for today's session, folks. It was really a wonderful and a fantastic session with you all. I loved and enjoyed it. I would be seeing you guys again in the next session. Till then, bye-bye. Take care and love you all. Bye-bye.